Hi students, welcome to 10th standard max mensuration session 2. In the last session we will discuss cube, cuboid and cylinder, so areas, surface areas, lateral surface area, total surface area and volume. But in this section I am going to explain about remaining 3D figures. So today's section, mensuration session 2. In this session we will discuss 3D object cone. What is a cone? So look at the picture. Cone is a 3D shape and it contains radius and height, vertical height and slant height also. Already you learnt in last 9th class, last year class. Radius R, vertical height H and slant height L. Base in the shape of a circular shape, but cone is formed by sector. Do you know a sector? It contains length of arc and two radii. A radius convert into slant height and length of arc convert into circumference of a circle. So coming to the concept, a right circular cone is a solid generated by the revolution of a right angle triangle about one of its side containing the right angle as axis as shown in the figure. Let height of a right circular cone be h units and its radius r units. Here radius equals to r units and vertical height equals to h. This is slant height. This is right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. So do you know formula for right angle triangle? Theorem for right angle, Pythagorean theorem. Sum of squares of two sides equals to hypotenuse square. Here hypotenuse equals to slant height L. Slant height L. So based on the Pythagoras theorem, we'll derive the slant height value L. So slant height of a cone. Slant height of a cone. So slant height L is equals to root over R square plus H square. R square plus H square. So observe the diagram. It's the right angle triangle. L is hypotenuse. One opposite side H and another side R. Based on Pythagoras theorem, square of the hypotenuse is equals to R square plus H square. Means L square is equals to R square plus H square. Or L is equals to square root of R square plus H square. That is slant height L. In the last year, we learnt LSFA, CSFA cone, TSFA cone and volume of a cone. But sector divided into some triangles. So we can make number of triangles and we get cone. Are you clear? So based on the theorem, we'll write so many formulae. So slant height of the cone L is equals to root over R square plus H square. Units. And second one, CSA, curved surface area. Curved surface area, CSA cone. Yes, CSA is equals to pi R L. Pi R L. So R represents radius and L represents slant height. Are you clear? Next to TSA cone. So TSA cone means CSA of a cone plus base area. Base area. So what is shape of base here? So base in the shape of a circle. So area square equals to pi r square. Now TSA is equals to CSA plus base area, area of the base. CSA pi r l plus base area pi r square. Pi r square. What is common factor? Pi r comma. Write on the next step. TSA means total surface area of cone is equals to CSA of a cone plus area of the base. Here CSA is equals to pi RL. CSA is equals to pi RL plus base of the cone in the shape of a circle. Then area of a circle equals to pi R square. Pi RL plus pi R square square units. So what are the common factor here? Pi pi common and R R also common. Write down the common factors. Pi R common. Remaining L plus R. L plus R. Look, pi R into L, pi R L, pi R into R, pi R square. Very clear? So TSA, total surface area of a cone, is equals to pi R into L plus R square units. Coming to next concept. Here R is the base radius of the cone. L is slant height of cone. H is height of the cone. L is slant height, R is radius, H is height, then volume of a cone. Here volume of a cone, so relation between cylinder and cone. Here volume of a cone is depend on volume of cylinder, because you have to take one cylinder and one cone, but radius are equal. Radius of cone equals to radius of cylinder, and height of a cylinder equals to height of a cone also equal. Then what the relation between the volume of cylinder and volume of a cone? Volume of a cone equals to 1/3 of volume of cylinder. So based on the figure here, cone volume and cylinder volume, relation between cone volume and cylinder volume. So observe the figure. Here base of the cylinder and base of the cone also equal, means base radius, base diameter also equal, and height of the cone and height of the cylinder also equal. What the condition here? Base radius and height of cone and cylinder are equal, then volume of a cone is equals to 1/3 of volume of cylinder. Volume of cylinder equals to 3 times of cone. So what the formula for area of volume of a cylinder? Volume of cylinder equals to pi r square h, base area into height. Now 1/3 volume of cone is equals to 1/3 of cylinder, means 1/3 pi r square h cubic units, because volume is always represented by cubic units. Write down the notes part. The capacity of a cone, is 1/3 of the capacity of the cylinder. That means if we take 1/3 of the volume of cylinder, we get the formula for cone volume. Volume of a cone V is equals to 1/3 into pi r square h cubic units. What is the formula for volume of a cone? 1/3 into pi r square h cubic units. Here volume of a cone and volume of cylinder, these two are relative to each other. Volume of cone is depend on volume of cylinder. If base radius and base radius and height of cone and cylinder are equal, then volume of cone is equals to 1/3 of volume of cylinder. That is the relation between cone volume and cylinder volume. Then volume of cone is equals to 1/3 into pi r square h cubic units. Now next. Okay children, let us move on to the next concept, sphere. Do you know sphere? So best example for sphere, marble. And a sphere is two types: hollow sphere or spherical shell or solid sphere. So marble is the best example for solid sphere. Cricket ball, football, these are example for hollow sphere or spherical shell. So observe the figure. This is the sphere. This is center of the sphere. Distance between center to any point on the sphere is called radius. Already we learnt in 9th class. So coming to the notes part, a sphere is a three-dimensional space, 3D space, such as the shape of a football. A sphere is a body bounded by surface whose every point is equidistant from a fixed point. Equidistant from a fixed point is called center or the origin of the sphere. Equidistant from means center to any point. Center to any point, that is equidistant from the center. The point name is called center or origin or origin. So distance between center to any point, center to any point is called radius. Like a circle in three dimensions, all points from the center are constant. Constant means same distance. Suppose distance between center to any point on the sphere 4 centimeters and another distance also 4. You can draw any distance, all are equal, that's called equidistant or equal distance, always constant, always constant. The distance from the center to any points on the boundary is known as the radius of the sphere, radius r. The maximum straight distance through the sphere is known as the diameter of the sphere. The maximum straight distance means complete covered with one time or diameter. So complete circumference. The maximum straight distance through the space is known as the diameter of the sphere. Diameter of the sphere. Coming to next point. Okay, student, let us move on to the next concept, surface area of a sphere. So observe the figure. Here radius r, surface area. Already we learnt in 9th class, in previous class. Take one circle and a sphere, both radii are equal. Radius of a sphere and radius of a circle are equal. And at the same time, have to take same radius of thread. Now start with cover the sphere, have to cover with complete sphere, we want 4 bundles of circles, thread circles. So now what do you observe? Area of surface area of sphere equals to 4 times of area of circle. 4 times of area of circle. So area of surface area of sphere equals to 4 into area of circle. So formula for area of circle equal to pi r square. 4 times means 4 pi r square. Surface area of a sphere is equals to 4 pi r square. 4 pi r square. Are you clear? 4 pi r square square units. Now volume. Now draw complete diameters on the sphere. So draw one figure from origin to any point on the diameters. Now we'll get one pyramid. Already we learned in 9th class. So area of pyramid. So sphere means some number of pyramids. So we get volume of a sphere based on the pyramid area, pyramid volume. So volume of sphere is equals to 4 by 3 pi r cube cubic units. Are you clear? The surface area of a sphere equals to 4 pi r square units. Volume of a sphere equals to 4 by 3 pi r cube cubic units. Coming to next concept, hemisphere. Do you know hemisphere? Hemisphere means half sphere. A sphere divided into two equal halves. Each and every part is called hemisphere. Here one thing, children, even surface area also half. Volume also half. Very clear? Coming to hemisphere. Look at the picture. This is the hemisphere diagram. But here sphere contains only one surface area. But hemisphere contains two surface areas. One is curved surface area and one is flat surface area. But flat surface area in the form of a circle shape. circular shape. Are you clear? So area of circle equals to pi r square and curved surface area. So exact half part, exact half part. So surface area of a sphere equals to 4 pi r square. Half means 2 pi r square. 2 pi r square. Are you clear? So coming to the point, hemisphere. One half of the sphere means exact half part. Exact half part is called a hemisphere. One half of a sphere is called hemisphere. Let radius of a hemisphere r. Let radius of a hemisphere r. Even height also r. Height is equal to r. Reason, this is center. Distance between center to any point on the boundary is called radius. Here h and r are equal. H and r also equal. Radius equals to r and height also r. Are you clear? Then curved surface of a hemisphere. CSA of a hemisphere. So CSA. CSA means half of the curved surface area, half part of the sphere. Half part of the sphere. So sphere, surface area sphere 4 pi r square, half part 2 pi r square, half part 2 pi r square means half into surface area of a sphere. Half into surface area sphere equals to 4 pi r square, half 4 pi r square, half 4 pi r square are 2 pi r square square units. What the formula for surface area of a hemisphere, surface area, curved surface area of a hemisphere? 2 pi r square. Hemisphere contains CSA and TSA also. But sphere contains only one surface area and hemisphere contains CSA, curved surface area, and a total surface area. So CSA of a hemisphere equals to 2 pi r square square units. Let us move on to the next concept. Total surface area of a hemisphere. Total surface area of a hemisphere. So TSA means CSA half a hemisphere plus base area. Base area. Here CSA equals to 2 pi r square. CSA equals to 2 pi r square. Base in the shape of circle. So area of circle equals to pi r square. This is written as TSA of a hemisphere equals to CSA curved surface area plus area of its base. Area of its base. So CSA 2 pi r square plus area of base pi r square. Now we'll get 3 pi r square square units. 3 pi r square square units. Are you clear? So TSA of a hemisphere equals to 3 pi r square. CSA 2 pi r square. Now going to volume. Volume of a hemisphere. So what the formula for volume of a sphere? 4 by 3 pi r cube. Hemisphere means exact half part of sphere. Even volume also half part of the sphere. So volume of hemisphere equals to half into volume of a sphere. Half into volume of a sphere. So half into volume of a sphere equals to 4 by 3 into pi r cube. 4 by 3 into pi r cube. So 2 1s are 2 2s are. Remaining 2 by 3 pi r cube. So volume of a hemisphere equals to 2 by 3 pi r cube cubic units. So just once revise formula. CSA of a hemisphere 2 pi r square. TSA of a hemisphere 3 pi r square. Volume of a hemisphere 2 by 3 pi r cube cubic units. Are you clear? Now coming to next. Okay students, let us move on to the next concept. What is the next concept? Spherical shell. Spherical shell. So do you know spherical shell? Yes, spherical shell means best example. Not cricket ball, stumper ball or rubber ball. A cricket ball means at two types, thread ball and the cork ball. These two are solid spheres. But stumper ball is the best example for spherical shell, and football also best example for spherical shell. So spherical shell means the solid enclosed between two concentric spheres is called spherical shell. What is the definition? The solid enclosed between two concentric spheres is called spherical shell. So look at the picture. This is the spherical shell, half part. Half part means semi-spherical shell. So complete part is called spherical shell. Like half part of coconut. Are you clear? Here, base. This complete curved surface area. So this part represents circular parts. Circular parts. So like this shape. This is outer circumference. This is inner circumference. And this is inner radius. This is outer radius. But here we have to use two radii, bigger radius and smaller radius, bigger circumference and smaller circumference, outer circumference and inner circumference. Are you clear? So coming to the formulae, thickness, thickness of shell. Thickness means difference between outer radius and inner radius, outer radius and inner radius. This is called thickness, thickness of the shell, thickness of the shell. So we have to find thickness equals to bigger minus smaller, bigger minus smaller. That is thickness of shell. Are you clear? Next one, outer surface area. Outer surface area. So outer surface area is written as outer surface area. This is complete sphere. You know surface area of sphere? 4 pi r square. Now here outer surface area means outer radius, means bigger. 4 pi big r square. 4 pi big R square. That is outer surface area of a spherical shell. Inner surface area? 4 pi small r square. Are you clear? Inner surface area means we have to use inner radius, small r. Outer radius, so outer surface area means we have to apply big R, capital R. Now, inner surface area. Inner surface area is equals to 4 pi small r square. 4 pi small r square. Are you clear? Next point. Volume. Volume is written as 4 by 3 pi. Do you know formula for sphere? Volume of a sphere? 4 by 3 pi r cube. 4 by 3 pi r cube. Here 4 by 3 pi big r cube minus small r cube. Big r cube minus small r cube. Because it contains outer volume and inner volume. Outer volume and inner volume. 4 by 3 pi r cube minus 4 by 3 pi small r cube. This is a volume, complete volume, complete volume. So how to find the volume of a spherical shell? Outer volume minus inner volume, outer volume minus inner volume. Outer volume formula, 4 by 3 pi big r cube minus 4 by 3 pi small r cube. So 4 by 3 pi common, 4 by 3 pi into big r cube minus small r cube, cubic unit. Units. That is the formula for volume of a spherical shell. Now let us move on to the next concept. Hemispherical shell means half part of spherical shell. Half part of, so best example, half part of coconut piece. Half part of coconut piece. Look at the picture. This is a hemispherical shell. Hemispherical shell. Here also we have to use two radius. This is the first radius smaller. And this is a second radius bigger. Difference between that red color represents thickness. Red color represents thickness. Bigger minus smaller. Bigger minus smaller. Are you clear? So the solid enclosure between two concentric hemispheres. Do you know what is meant by concentric? Concentric means center is same. If two circles are having same center. If two circles are having same center is called concentric circles. A concentric hemispheres means center is same. This is the first circle and this is the second circle. Both first circle and second circle means inner circle and outer circle are having same center origin. So this is called concentric circle. If two solid enclosed between two concentric hemispheres is called spherical shell. Spherical shell. The solid enclosure between two concentric hemispheres. Two concentric hemispheres is called spherical shell. Are you clear? Here external radius means outer radius bigger. Outer radius bigger. Inner radius smaller. Outer radius bigger. Air external radius bigger. Internal radius smaller. Or inner radius smaller. Now thickness. Thickness means here red color represents thickness. Bigger minus smaller units. Thickness of shell equals to big R minus small r units. Outer surface area, or outer here, hemispherical shell contains two areas, outer surface area. This is outer curved surface area. Outer curved surface area, outer curved surface area equals to 2 pi big R square. Do you know formula for hemisphere? CS of hemisphere, 2 pi R square. But it contains two curved surface areas. One is outer curved surface area and another one is inner curved surface area. Are you clear? Here outer curved surface area. Outer curved surface area means you have to apply big R. Outer curved surface area, 2 pi big R square, 2 pi big R square. Inner curved surface area, inner curved surface area means 2 pi small r square, 2 pi small r square, square units. Now, total surface area. Total surface area means curved surface area plus base area. This is written as 2 pi r square, 2 pi big r square, 2 pi big r square plus 2 pi small r square. Means outer surface area 2 pi small r square units plus 2 pi small r square, 2 pi big r square plus 2 pi small r square plus area of ring. Area of ring. Do you know formula for area of ring? Pi into big r square minus small r square. Simplification. Here pi is common. Pi is common because 2 pi r square and pi into r square, pi r square. Pi into small r square, pi small r square. 2 pi r square plus pi r square, 3 pi r square. 3 pi r square. And 2 pi r square minus r square plus r square. Here pi common plus 3 big r square plus small r square. Square units. This is the formula for total surface area of a hemispherical shell. Volume of material. Volume of material. So volume. So here volume is equals to. Do you know formula for volume of a hemisphere? 2 by 3 pi r cube. Pi r cube. Here 2 by 3 pi into big R cube minus small r cube. Big R cube minus small r cube. 2 by 3 pi into big R cube minus small r cube cubic units. The formula for volume of a hemispherical shell. Are you clear? So let us move on to the next one. Question number 1. Listen, children. It's very easy question, but in this section, but especially questions, so I will divide into 4 parts. First of all, analyze the question. 2 cubes, each volume 64 centimeter cube, are joined end to end. Find the surface area of the resulting cuboid. What is given question? 2 cubes, each of volume 64 centimeter cube, are joined each to joined end to end. Find the surface area of the resulting cuboid. What is given question? 2 cubes are given, each one having 64 centimeter cube. These two are joined with each other. Now we will get one cuboid. Find surface area of a resulting cuboid. That is given question. This is given question is a difficult question or easy question or medium or average question. So you have to analyze the question. First, difficulty level, medium question. Because this is 7th class and 8th class concept. That's why medium question. Medium level, not hard level, not an easy level, medium level. And second one, known by given. So what are given concepts? 2 cubes, each volume 64. 2 cubes. Each volume 64 cubes, centimeter cube, are joined end to end. This is given concept. And second one, unknown. What is the unknown? Surface area of the resultant cuboid. Now you have to find surface area of the resultant cuboid. That is unknown. When 2 cubes are joined end to end. This is completely unknown part. Then you have to find surface area of the resulting cuboid. And next one, reasoning. What is the reasoning? We will find the length of edge of a cube by using the formula for volume of a cube where length of edge is a. So length of edge is a. So analyze the question first. What is given question? Cube. 2 cubes are joined each other. Edge of a cube is a. We will get one cuboid. Cuboid contains length, breadth and height. That is complete reasoning part. Are you clear? Let length of edge is a units. To solution part, using the formula surface area of cuboid, two cubes are joined with each other, we will get cuboid. What is the formula for surface area of cuboid? Surface area means total surface area, 2 into lb plus bh plus lh, where l, b and h are length, breadth and height. Length, breadth and height are respectively. Are you clear? Coming to solution, let length of edge of a cube, what a given condition? Given conditions are two cubes. So let length of edge of each cube is a, therefore volume of a cube, a cube, formula for volume of cube equals to a cube. Based on the question, volume of each cube equals to 64 centimeter cube. So formula for cube, volume of a cube is equals to a cube cubic units. So draw the two pictures. This is the first cube, edge of a cube is a units, and this is second cube, edge of a cube is a units. These two are joined with each other. Now we'll get one new figure, cuboid. Here a plus a, one edge plus and edge of first cube plus edge of another cube becomes length of cuboid. Length of cuboid, now length equals to a plus a, length equals to a plus a, and the breadth is equals to same, breadth equals to a, and height equals to same, height equals to a. Are you clear? Height equals to a units, length equals to 2a units, and the breadth equals to a units. Now volume of a cube, what is the given volume of a cube? 64 centimeter cube, 64 centimeter cube. Here a cube equals to 64. The 64 written as into cubical form, 4 into 4 into 4, 4 into 4, 16, 16 to 4, 64. Now a whole cube is equals to 64 written as 4 whole cube. A whole cube equals to 4 whole cube centimeter cube. So a cube equal 4 cube, then a is equals to 4. Are you clear? A is equals to 4. So a means edge of a cube. Are you clear? A equals to edge of a cube. Then a is equals to 4 centimeters. Here a equal 4 centimeters. Here length equals to a plus a, 2a. Length equals to 2a. Breadth equals to a, means breadth a plus a, means length equals to 8 centimeters. Breadth equals to 4 centimeters, and height also 4 centimeters. Now find TS of a cuboid. Are you clear? Coming to next. Okay, let us move on to the next concept, cuboid. Therefore, length of resulting cuboid, L is equals to 2A. Here length a plus a, 2A. Length 2A equals 2 into 4, 8. Length equal to 8 centimeters. Breadth equal to 4 centimeters, and height equals to 4 centimeters. The length of the resulting cuboid L equals 2A equals to 8 centimeters. Breadth of the resulting cuboid B equals to A equal to 4 centimeters, and the height of resulting cuboid H equals to 4 centimeters. Do you know formula for TS of a cuboid? So surface area of the resulting cuboid 2 into LB plus BH plus LH square units. So substitute these three values in the given formula. 2 into LB. LB means 8 into 4. 8 into 4. 8 centimeter into 4 centimeter plus BH, 4 centimeter into 4 centimeter plus LH, 8 centimeter into 4 centimeter. 2 into 8 into 4. 8 centimeter into 4 centimeter. 8 into 4, 32 centimeter 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 square plus 4 into 4. 16 centimeter 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 square plus 18 into 4, 32 centimeter and centimeter centimeter square. Now 2 into 32 plus 16 plus 32, we get 80. Okay, 2 plus 6, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, remaining 1, 1 plus 3, 4, plus 1, 5, 5 plus 3, 8. So 2 into 80 centimeter square. 2 into 80, 160 centimeter square. This is the surface area of a resulting cuboid. So what is the surface area of resulting cuboid? 160 centimeter square. So if two cubes are joined to each other, but each cube contains 64 centimeter cube volume, will get surface area of resultant cuboid is 160 centimeter square. Are you clear, children? Thank you. But in the next section, we will discuss so many questions. Okay, thank you.